Hello everybody, I said I'd atone for playing a game that I'd already played before on One Credit Champ, and what better way of doing that than playing a game that I've already played before? Well, not technically. Last time we played Daytona, it was the arcade version ported to the Xbox 360. This is clearly the far superior Dreamcast version, Daytona 2001. So I guess it might be a good idea to press the starty go now button, and I think we will choose a single race, yeah. Now, being a version of the game built with a home console in mind, it's got a whole lot of options, such as changing your car and the rules of the race. So instead of doing any of that, I'm going to drive the good old Hornet and race on 3.7 Speedway with 8 laps and 40 cars. Just like the arcade, because there's nothing like a little variety, and this is nothing like a little variety. Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines. Rolling Let's do this then. Daytona 2001 was developed by Amusement Vision, a division at Sega from when they went a bit mental during the Dreamcast era and spun off their AM units into different subsidiary companies. AV, as they were also known, were previously known as R&D Department 4, and before that AM11, and consisted of ex-members of AM2. Headed by the designer of Daytona and now brainchild behind the Yakuza games, Toshihiro Nagoshi, and also including the likes of AM2 programmer extraordinaire, the bin man himself, Satoshi Mifune, I'm going around the corner. AV were helped in the production of this title by an external team called Genki, who'd worked with Sega in the past on some pretty mediocre shit, like Hang On GP on the Saturn. They were also responsible for porting Virtua Fighter 3 TB from Naomi to Dreamcast. So I guess they weren't all bad, just partially bad. So despite having the man that designed the original game overseeing the project, many hardcore Daytona fans get their panties in a bunch over Daytona 2001, claiming the physics are wrong and the controls are too sensitive. And whilst I disagree strongly about the physics, there are certainly analog sensitivity issues. Thankfully, there is a calibration screen where you can set the dead zone and range, and on the Western versions, even dial down the sensitivity. Alas, that isn't enough for some people. They should consider themselves lucky. I have the Japanese version and can't dial down that sensitivity. And you know what? I still fucking love this game. So why don't you do one, you complainy complainers? I bet you're the same type of people that moan that Burnout Paradise is the worst Burnout. I'll have you know, I've put more hours into Paradise than the rest of the Burnout games combined. It might be the worst one, but it's a better game because of it. And I'll fucking fight anyone that disagrees. And I'll bring a lead pipe and I'll cave their fucking head in. Stop being bitches. I've totally gone off topic. I have no idea where I'm going from here. Oh God, let's sum this thing up. Daytona 2001 is the original game, with tracks from the arcade, Saturn CC editions, and three original ones too. Nothing from Daytona 2 though, because nobody gives a shit about Daytona 2. It's got a better draw distance and far superior graphics to the arcade. It's got remixed music. The Sonic carved into the cliff over there wasn't replaced by the green-eyed douchebag. Everything is just fine. Fine. Everything is fine. And with that all over and done with, we've achieved first place. That's a nice thing, although maybe I've overstated how fine everything is, because that game over jingle is plainly wrong. Just wrong. Where's the voo? Where's the voo? Never mind, it's name in time, and I don't think the Dreamcast version allows for secret jingles. So let's just put in the old standard. There's the U. There's the M. Bum end. Right then. Fuck it. Let's do another track. One of the new ones, maybe. Nah, Dinosaur Canyon is. Like I even remember the racing line on any of those other tracks. It has been 17 years, after all. Anyway, everything okay? Yeah, pretty much. Let's start the race then. Ladies and gentle beans, start your engine beans. Yeah, that's never going to become a catchphrase, right? Let's do the hot start. Oh, yeah, that worked like a dream. So anyway, I wanted to cover this because Daytona 3, or as it's been renamed, simply Daytona Championship USA, has been in the news a bit recently. Obviously, it was finally released at arcades last year to not much fanfare from the Sega Racing Hardcore. And I don't think it helped that the earliest version of the game we saw was housed in cabinets that were clearly based on the one used for Outrun 2 that had a simple up-down gear stick instead of a four-way H-shifter. Everyone knows that the 4-2-3-4 shift is essential to getting a good drift around some of the corners, sometimes even 4 all the way to 1. Apparently the newer cabinets do indeed have the proper gear shifter though, so that's good news. But when it comes to Daytona 3 news, that's some small fry shit! Because something happened at the end of last year. Sega released a free software update for arcade operators at the end of 2017. The problem was, it wasn't just a patch, it was the whole bloody game. Freely downloadable from Sega's servers, and like all of Sega's recent arcade titles, it runs on Windows-based PC hardware. So within days, resourceful hackers had it running on Windows. Within a week, they'd sorted it to run on standard PC controllers and wheels. Yes! Sega gave away Daytona 3, currently supposedly an arcade exclusive. Free! To everyone! Temporarily! By accident! Thank God Sega don't consistently make mistakes like that, eh? Like releasing the full version of Yakuza 6 to PSN instead of the demo. My God, imagine if that happened, eh? Anywho, this little blunder means that Daytona 3 has had a little more exposure than it would have if it was just stuck in arcades. It means I've gotten to see it, and there's not much to write home about. It steals its music straight from this version, removes the fucking Fruit Machine reels from the Archer 3.7 Speedway. The new circuits are just reskinned mirror races. None of the CCE, Daytona 2 or 2001 tracks are in it. So if you like a bit of Desert City, Joopolis 2020 or Circuit Pixie, you're shit out of luck. You may have heard me state before that the original Daytona has been cited as one of the reasons the arcade industry shrank the way it did. Once an operator got a Daytona cab, it made such good money, consistently, they never needed to replace it. 9 years ago, Sega re-released Daytona to arcades as Sega Racing Classic in order to replace all the dying Model 2 cabinets. The question is, are arcade operators going to bother replacing them again? I honestly don't know. Sega Racing Classic was replacing proprietary hardware and CRT screens with modular PC-style hardware and LCDs, technology that's still relatively repairable or replaceable without having to buy a whole new cabinet. So the question is, what does Daytona 3 have that the old game doesn't? And I'm not counting a couple of mirror tracks or some higher definition graphics. You know what it's got? A fucking camera so you can see your ugly face on screen. Because for some reason, that's a thing now in races, and that's it. And I don't think that's enough. Oh shit, no! There I was, hoping for a somewhat perfect race, only to bin it on the last corner. I know I could wobble over that finish line in first place, I know I probably earned it, but I have standards, and I feel that I'm just not good enough. Sometimes you just have to look back on your achievements and ask, is this good enough? Do I deserve the reward? Or am I just an embarrassment to whoever sponsors me? And maybe the world would be better off if I just quit. As if! Until next time, bye! And